Fun is for another chippy as well, chippy's close.
Kijk, ik zal aan die bobo werken als jij aan die kar werkt, oké? Okay.
Deal.
No 4-year-olds. They break everything. Anyways, I think it's time to put the snorkel on the real defender so that we can hide the hole on the side of the car. Okay guys, so let's prep the snorkel. I'm going to stick a closed foam strip around the outside edge, allowing for maximum compression and sealing. I've basically put it on the outer edge to make sure there's no water ingress. I will cut it out on the inside with a knife so that fits easily, and then I've got another thin one I'll put on this edging. As you see, I added two layers of sealant, one top outside edge and one on the lower inside edge. This allows for wider compressible area. Basically, I've used gum to seal the intake, so there's literally no place water can get into the system. From factory, the snorkels are mounted with a bracket that sits on those two points there. Let me show you guys. It hooks over there, and then yeah, I don't have it straight, but then you drill those holes accordingly, which is horrible. It sits quite a far away from the window frame and it's higher than it needs to be on top. So what I'm going to do is, these two holes there are basically perfectly lined for the, as those two holes there, like you can see there. So I'll use that as a placement. It also brings the snorkel down, which means it's closer to the window frame and it doesn't stick out as much, which I believe looks better. So the reason I added the sealant around the edge is to move it away so that it sits closer. Let me just do that for you. If I use the holes I mentioned, it sits around about there, which is quite close. It's, I don't know, you won't probably see this, but it's aligned with those two I mentioned. And see how close it is to the window frame. And also on top, it doesn't stick out like a flag. So if I use the holes it's designed to sit with, yeah, then that's what you have. So it's quite a lot higher and there's quite a big gap. Also on that side, there's like a crazy gap. So that's why I'm going to use the bottom two holes. Okay guys, I need to install rev nuts on those two holes that I drilled. That's for the two top holes on the snorkel to fit it from the outside. The rest of them get tied down from the inside. So the way I'm going to do this is, I've unfortunately don't have a rivnut nut gun. So I've got a bolt I put a nut on, and then I've got the rivnut nut on the end with a few washers in between. So what I do then is I hold a nut in place with a spanner or something, and then turn this nut to pull and crimp the rivnut nut to stay in place. That's the easiest way to do it without spending a grand on a proper rivnut. The cheap ones, two or three nuts and it breaks. So yeah, basically that's how I'm going to do this. Putting the rivnuts on, I'm going to put this in place. I'm going to hold it here and then just keep tightening this bolt until it collapses. Fortunately, you can see at the bottom how far it collapsed. So so you can't really mess it up. Just keep tightening this until it basically compresses the rivnut and it collapses and it tightens itself from the arc. So you feel it getting quite tough to turn. Still go a bit. Have a look there. You guys can see. And if you can see on the inside, but it basically compressed and pulled itself in. I'm sure it can go still a bit. And I'll probably do that just off camera and see if I can pull it tighter. And then I'm going to do that one, same thing. And yeah, then I've got my two holding points done and dusted. Okay, so now that I've got that done, the washers that came with the kit was a bit oversized, so I had to use a socket and hit it in with a hammer. So it's sitting in the right place now. Okay guys, to show you what it looks like, I've got plastic covers and pushers in there to close that. And then, yeah, look at that nice gap, as well as the gap there. It doesn't sit, you know, somewhere in Jupiter, so that's brilliant. Yeah, now I can remove it, mark all the other holes off, and take it from there. Okay guys, so I'm gonna mark everything up so that we can make the holes to tighten it down from behind, just using those two. So the idea is to drill a pilot hole, a very small . So I need to get in here to put bolts from behind. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the fender. So to do that, you basically need to remove all these plastic fenders. And the secret to that is to push the pin in and not lose it. Okay, so I'm going to do that, otherwise, and then from there I'll just tighten it down and then I should be almost done. I pushed the pins in using an Allen key. Basically that's what it looks like with a pin, so if you push it through it falls out and just catch them every time, and then yeah, it opens up or it becomes loose and you can pull it out. I use the trim tool that works quite nice, so I've got one or two more to go and then I'll take it off and show you guys. So as you can see, I pushed two of the bolts through, but this one right there is, if you look there, you can see the plastic behind it, so it's part of the intake sitting there. So there's not enough gap to basically get a bolt in. But what I've done is, if you look at that, I made a stud. So the secret to making a stud is when you cut it off, to grind it 45 degrees afterwards, and then it works quite nice. So I'm gonna put a stud in the front, and I can at least from the side get in with a spanner, and then when I've done that, I can tighten a nut from that side, and that should be a good way to do it. So I'll put the side I grinded 45 in first, and as you can see it sticks out enough on that side to basically be able to push into the hole and get a nut from the other side. Okay, so let's get this on and we'll take it from there. I'm marking this. I've basically marked it and just drilled a pilot. I haven't made a hole yet, but I just made a place to measure it. I'm gonna drill an M5 and tap it M6 so that I can use some of the bolts that I've got with the kit to pull that against the screen and take it from there. Anyways, guys, so I made a 5mm hole and I'm going to tap it 6mm now. So got everything on. Put some sealant in the back there because I don't like stainless steel against aluminium. I don't know if you've ever googled and found it could cause corrosion, so I just put some silicone in between. I've also put some nail polish on the nuts to make sure it doesn't rattle somewhere. Just put a fender on quickly and then I'm done. And there's your finished product. Looks good. It's not too high. The gap is decent. And like I showed you, it's quite close to the fender. So it's not the easiest way to do it, but it definitely has its benefits. Okay guys, hope you enjoyed the video. See you soon.